Okay, the next speaker is Maxim Sheshkov from the Institute of Mathematical Problems of Biology. Maxim was also a member of the, is also a member of the program committee, and he helped us review abstracts for the contributed sessions. Maxim will be talking about filling gaps in earthworm digital diversity in northern Eurasia from Russian language literature. All yours, Max.
I would like to present communication about data mobilization from scientific literature on a particular taxonomic group at the regional scale. Next slide, please. Earthworms is a key group of organisms which able, despite their modest size, drastically alter carbon cycle locally, and they drive many processes in soil and impact carbon turnover and balance globally. At the same time, the volume of available data of earthworm species distribution is scarce, especially for the territory of northern Eurasia. Next, please. On this territory, this taxonomic group has been and being studied by dozens researchers of several generations, and overwhelming majority of the research results have been published in Russian languages. Language not only in scientific journals, but also in so-called gray literature. This series hampers the dissemination of this knowledge to the global community and uses this data for research. For example, for species distribution modeling, and our purpose to mobilize this data. Next, please. For filling these gaps, we have summarized this data from more than 100 and half Russian language scientific papers of earthworms published in Russian from the end of 19th century to the present day. It tests time span of more than 100 and half years. We published datasets ZRUDGBIF, and the datasets covers territories of 27 countries and reflects material collected by most prominent Soviet and Russian specialists on earthworms, both systematics and ecologists. Next, please. Without our dataset, the time scope of available data ZRUDGBIF for territory of North Eurasia was extended back some more 30 years. next, please. And we extended this time range more than 100 years backward, which may be important for the study of range dynamics, as some earthworm species have invasive potential. And as we can see, at the global scale, our recently published dataset became ninth in terms of number of occurrences. Next, please. In the same time, the data we collected from the literature appeared to be very not very good in terms of the georeferencing. A minority of occurrences we extracted from literature contained explicit geographic coordinates. Most of them were geolocated by ourselves using the textual description of localities. For example, for the territory of European part of Russia, more than and for five more abundant species, more than half records were georeferenced with uncertainly greater than 1 kilometer, that hampering using of this occurrence for species distribution modeling, for example. Such pattern is specific for entire data sets. It only 2/3 of the occurrence could be he allocated using available textual information. We have not allocated occurrence with when uncertainly to be more than 100 kilometers. Next, please. And after then, we thought about what other data sources could be used and decide to consider citizen science in general and the well-known system iNaturalist in particular. But some scientists are skeptical regarding such sources, however, and do not consider iNaturalist as a reliable source of data, but we don't agree with them. Although dealing with iNaturalist, observation requires considerable efforts of on data curation. First, we are able to verify species identification independently, and secondly, it is possible to communicate with observers and identifiers personally to and obtain additional details regarding each observation. But it should be kept in mind that this data were collected very recently, not earlier than 3-4 years ago, and could be and this data can be in append, not the substitution of heritage data from literature. Next slide, please. We decided to review data on Earthworms from iNaturalist and concerned considering that much of this data was collected by amateur observers rather than professional researchers, we developed quality assessment criteria for such data. The date of observation must be valid, and the location of the observation should be accurate, and each observation must be identified by at least two experts who are professional lumbricologists. Next, please. And for convenience of identification and reviewing of such data, a distinct iNaturalist project covering the whole Northern Eurasia earthworms has been created. And by this criteria, we checked most iNaturalist observation for our area of interest. Next, please. The main expert in this project are researchers from Russia and France. And the another important purpose of this project is to prevent the accumulation of wrong biodiversity data on this group, which also goes to GBIF and could be used in investigation. Next, please. This direction is to facilitate visual model development in iNaturalist that automatically suggests identification based on images. A new version of neural network visual model in iNaturalist comes monthly, but the main issues regarding earthworms still persist. The model is not very good at distinguishing earthworm species, because every long and segmented thing could be identified as Lumbricus terrestris species by iNaturalist visual model, and most users accept such suggested investigations. Here we can see that this obvious different species of worms, and one species, it is not a worm at all, it is millipede. Next, please. The present version of the model includes four earthworm species. One of them pale, another is growth striped, but two others have a very similar appearance. And I have doubts that the model can distinguish these species confidently, because the main differences is which segments comprise the feature important for identification. And I'm not sure that the neural network catches it. But in any case, we need a photo of high quality to make a confident identification. And however, majority of such data passing through our data cleaning process is marked at the level of family or even order regarding identification due to low quality of images, and thus go to the unidentifiable for at species level. First of all, due to low
you
quality
got one more
of
minute,
photos.
Maxim.
Next. Okay. As a result of this verification, we supplement Hazard data with new occurrence, and in addition, we found that georeferences of modern data derived from iNaturalist is more accurate compared to literature data. And it's the first 100 or 10s of meters. Next, please. And finally, we can conclude that by publishing of new literature-based dataset, we not only covered some spatial gaps on earthworms for the territory of Northern Eurasia, but also extending time span back more than 100 years. And two sources that we considered complements is also very well. Literature data provide confident identification data, but not very accurate geolocation. And naturalist observation usually have geographic coordinates with small uncertainty, but often not very reliable identification, but we're able to verify it. And this work is the first step of project aimed to distribution modeling of the main azure species of Northern Eurasia. Next, please. Thank you for your attention.
Thanks very much, Maxim. I think we have time for one or two questions. There are, Steve? And nothing from the room either? And thanks very much again, Maxim. Can you next?
Thank you.